It was an historic day at Edwards Air Force Base as NASA's Dryden Flight Research Center was renamed after a famous astronaut. 17's Paul Harris was at Edwards today for the ceremony and has this report.
Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave?
Callie Armstrong, granddaughter of legendary astronaut Neil Armstrong, sings the national anthem before the NASA Dryden Flight Research Center at Edwards Air Force Base is renamed in her grandfather's honor. Congressman Kevin McCarthy spearheaded the legislation to get the name change, a process that took 9 years.
To be here today, it took an act of Congress. You know what the little sad part? I had to pass it twice.
The NASA Flight Research Center, which advances technology and science through flight, was renamed after Hugh Dryden 38 years ago. Dryden was a pioneer in aviation, helping to design the P-51 Mustang and lobbied President Kennedy to create the Apollo program. Dryden passed away from cancer in 1965, and his grandson was at the ceremony to honor him.
I think he was a very humble individual. Didn't expect to have a facility named for him in the first place. So I think he'd be very pleased and proud to transfer the name over to Neil Armstrong.
Long before Armstrong died in 2012, his imprint on the moon on July 20th, 1969, influenced a generation.
It's one small step for man, one giant leap for mankind.
But he took his first steps at Edwards as a test pilot in the 1950s, testing aircraft like the X-15, currently the world record holder for the fastest manned aircraft.
While the event celebrated the accomplishments of Dryden and Armstrong, family members spoke more about looking ahead to the future.
If you stick with something and have no limits, then you'll do very well and go very far.
May this center flourish. As long as we have the dreams to fly faster and farther than ever before, and to make real that which we have imagined.